Two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come. When God sends a perfect one, now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when He created you. I wonder if He knew everything I would need, because He made all my dreams come true. When God made you, He must have been thinking about me.
I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know I let nothing come between us, and I will love the ones you love. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life.
I wonder what God was thinking made all my dreams come true. When God made you, He must have been thinking about me. He made the sun, He made the moon to harmonize in perfect tune. One can't move without the other. They just have to be together.
gathered together this afternoon in the sight of God with friends and family to witness the joining in holy matrimony of Justin and Kelly. You make a beautiful couple. Kelly, I'm just a little bit concerned. Right now I'm supposed to say you're holding on to your dad and he's wearing a weapon. I'm not real sure what we're going to do. I'm still going to take a chance. I'm going to ask a question. Who gives this woman to this man to be married?
The mother and I.
It's here. This is the day that you've been waiting for. prayed for, you've planned on, and now you better be ready. Because you're getting married. This is for real. This is for keeps. Today is one of the most important days that's going to be in your entire life. Both of you, as you come today, changes everything about each of you. It's no longer Justin. It's no longer Kelly. From now on, it's Justin and Kelly. It's a together. I was thinking, I know the other night we had a chance to visit and to talk and all of that, but I want you don't have to keep this. I want you to look at it. This is a blank piece of paper. Just hold on to it. That's a blank piece of paper. If you look at it, that represents your marriage. There isn't anything on it. Nothing. There's no good days, no bad days, no discouragements, no problems, no struggles, nothing. But that represents who you are and what you are. In just a few moments, you are going to begin to write on that, and that's going to be the rest of your lives. Every day you're going to get up, and you're going to start a brand new page in the book of Justin and Kelly. What goes on there, you two determine. There's no erasers on it. You can't say, well, I want a do-over. There are no do-overs. Today, and I want to emphasize, the two of you determine what your marriage is going to say. And I have all confidence, I really do. I believe that we're going to have a beautiful, beautiful story. And we get to watch it unfold together as your friends and your family. This is where I like to just take my time because both of you are wanting to get on. I just like to just relax a little bit. Breathe. Justin, this is a promise you're making. You're making it both to Kelly and you're making it to God. Do you promise to take Kelly to be your lawful wedded wife, to love and cherish her, to honor her, keep her in sickness and in health, in times of plenty and in times of want, and leading all others, keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live? If so, say I do.
I do.
Kelly, likewise, you're making a promise, both to Justin, and you're making this to God. Kelly, do you promise to take Justin to be your lawful wedded husband, to cherish and love him, to honor and sustain him in sickness and in health, in times of plenty and in times of want, and leading all others to keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live? If so, say I do.
I do.
Justin, this is to you. I thought about this quite a bit the last day or two. I don't know where to begin. I've had the privilege of knowing you your entire life. I've been your pastor since the day you were born. I've watched you. I've always, you know, even when you were growing up and you were a kid and all, you still see characteristics developing and everything that was happening. And I'm going to tell you, you've grown into a great man. And I may refer to you as a kid, but you got to understand where I'm coming from. But I say, without any reservation, that I'm very proud of you. Very proud of you. I've watched now, from my perspective, as I think about you, others might say you've recently graduated from college, you've had a great education, You've entered into a great career. Life's going to be good. And some may say, man, that's awesome. But the Justin that I appreciate is a little bit different than that. I appreciate the man that I see in the prayer room before church service. I appreciate the one who prays, sings, and worships. I appreciate the man at times when a preacher, whether it's myself or someone else preaching, I see you raise a hand and lift it to God. These are your best qualities, Justin. This is more than any job, because the job only takes you so far. The others take you where it's really important. Justin, I charge you this afternoon in the fear of God to be a godly husband. To be a godly husband. And that takes in all the qualities that the scriptures tell us. I charge you to lead your wife. Although she lives for God, you now become the man that leads you. Lead her in living for God. You keep prayer as the center of your marriage. I started to bring out one of our morning prayers and hand it to both of you. There's nothing in your lives that's going to be more valuable than what your prayer lives are going to be. Prayer changes all. Prayer makes a way for all. Prayer gives what needs to be. And if you keep that before you. I also want to tell you, Justin, you take care of her. It's one thing to say, I love you and I want to marry you. It's another thing to take care of the woman that you want to marry. Paul admonishes, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church. And in just a short, short while, she's no longer your girlfriend. She becomes your wife. She becomes your wife. And in saying that, she becomes part of you. There's no magical formula for a successful marriage. You have to work at it. But I'm telling you right now that I have all the confidence in you. Justin, I want you to know I love you, and I will always be there for you. Bless you.
Kelly, this is a charge to you. I have watched you over the years. Your love for God, your fear of God, and your love for people. God has blessed you, and He requires you to love Him first and foremost, above all else. You will one day have to answer to God for the life that He's given you, the talents that He's blessed you with. Let God lead and guide your life as you and Justin enter into a new chapter in your book of life.
I want you, Justin, again, this is, I don't know how many weddings that I've done, and every time we get to this point, it's so easy just to go through it, say the words, and we're done. I just want to emphasize to both of you, this is a God thing. This is a God thing. Justin, Kelly, when you repeat after me in just a moment, I'm going to ask you to, Justin, first you look at your bride, and I want you to repeat, and this is a commitment you're making to her, then Kelly, vice versa in just a moment. Justin, if you'd repeat after me, I, Justin, take you, Kelly.
I, Justin, take you, Kelly.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To death do us part.
till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
And Kelly, if you would repeat and just make this to Justin. This is forever. I, Kelly, take you, Justin. To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
To cherish.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
All right.
Amen. Amen. Now we're ready for the ring.
Isn't it?
Justin, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I do wed.
And with all my earthly goods.
And with all my earthly goods.
I grant thee, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
I grant thee, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Kelly, repeat after me.
Put the ring on.
Repeat after me. With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And with all my earthly goods.
And with all my earthly goods.
I grant thee.
I grant thee.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Bless their future, bless their family.
told Justin it's so good to see a young couple get married in the Lord. We want it to stay that way. We're going to lay hands on them, but we're going to pray in Jesus' name. Praise
Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Christ, we pray. Yes, we ask for a blessing on their life. Trust in their parents. We pray, Lord, as they begin their book of life together, that they will serve you, John, man, through godliness and holiness, perfecting holiness in the spirit of life. We pray for both of them right now in your churches. Lord, that they will love one another, care one for another, for they too have become one flesh. We ask today for your guidance in their life, in their generation, in their livelihood, in their home, in their house of prayer. We ask these things in the matchless name of the Lord Jesus.
Yes,
Lord. And we give you thanks, Lord, for this beautiful God. Justin, if you so like, you can kiss your bride. I think you'd like to kiss her again, I'm not sure. I would like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Justin Jones.
I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. Moments I have been. Someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid, I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'll be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I do. Oh, someone warm like you. My life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore.